his college years, Dr. Yeo performed several major roles in operatic productions and also won several vocal competitions on both the state and regional levels. Dr. Yeo currently teaches at Harvest Christian Academy and Harvest Baptist Bible College on our neighboring island of Guam. Please welcome Dr. Yeo.
Thank you.
Next piece is entitled "God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen." It will be performed by our string ensemble. Please welcome them. Our sixth selection, Welcome the Child of Light, will be performed by all of our EIS and EIU choirs. Please welcome them. Thank you. and it will be performed by Dr. Yeo. Let's welcome him. Our next selection is Angels We Have Heard on High, performed again by our violin ensemble. Please welcome them. Thank you. Our next piece this evening is titled, O Come Emmanuel, and we perform by Dr. Yeo. Please welcome. Our next piece is a Christmas medley performed again by the kindergarten choir. Please welcome them. Thank you. Our final choir song this evening is called Jehovah Elohim. It will be performed by our upper elementary, junior high, high school, and university choirs. Please welcome them. Thank you. our final piece tonight, Dr. Yeo will be performing O Holy Night. Please welcome him.
Thank you.
Before we recognize and thank the musicians of the evening, I'd like to welcome Dr. Wei back to the podium.
Tonight, we have heard those sacred music. The sacred music has ranged between the Thanksgiving Day and the Christmas Day. The reason why we arrange this way is because that we do believe there's a God. And we do believe that we need to give thanks to this creator God. So we have a thanksgiving. If there's a no God, who we are going to give thanks to? We also believe that Jesus Christ has been arranged by the Father, came to this world on the Christmas Day. And therefore we celebrate Christmas. The word Christmas is centered on Christ. If there's no Christ, then Christmas is no meaning. Recently, I was involved into a panel discussion with Buddhism, and they invited three PhD in Buddha studies, and then with our group, three scholars in the Christianity, and to talk about different religions. But when we talk about those religions, I mean, they have a lot of a good concept. They have their own system. They're trying to describe what's happening in the world. There's a suffering in the world, there's a pain, there's a sickness, there's all kinds of difficulties and problems that a human being has to face. But they want to solve the problem of the death, of the pain, of suffering. But then when they go into their own system, then they think that they find a solution. However, we always want to know what is the truth. Because if you don't know the truth, no matter how good that concept or solution or any kinds of theory or religions or faith, if it is not true, then in the end, that's a tragedy. In human being, we are searching truth. When we're searching the truth, we need to understand what actually really happened. When the Bible said God created the universe, created a human being, we need to ask the question, is this really happened? Did it happen? Now, if it didn't happen, don't bother. But if it happened, then we need to take seriously. And so it's very important we need to know what is the truth. I mean, you cannot teach the children 1 + 1 = 2, then you say, well, 3 is okay, 4 is okay, I mean, everything is okay. You have to tell them what is the truth. And the truth is inclusive. My friend, you have to know that the truth has to be inclusive. You cannot give all the answers. You have to have one answer that's the truth. So when this debate with the Buddhism, we emphasize a very important question. Do you know you believe the truth? If your theory is not the truth, then everything falls apart. Jesus Christ came to this world. He proclaimed that he is the truth, the way, the truth, and the life. No one goes to the Father but through him. Now, my friend, you have to realize he's not telling that he is a better way or best way. He's not telling he is the best truth or Batichu or Bastu, or he is not telling he is a bad life or best life. He is telling he is the only way, and he is the only true, and he is the only life. No one go to the Father, go to the Creator God, but through Jesus Christ. If you miss Jesus Christ, if you miss this way, then there's no way. No other religions and no other name and no other theory that can help us to go to the Father. Only Jesus Christ. Now you may say, well, he may be lying. I agree, there's a possibility Jesus is lying. Now if Jesus is lying, then Christianity will be the most evil religions of the whole universe and the whole human race. And Jesus Christ will be the most evil liar of human history. But when you search the Lord Jesus' lifestyle, then you see that he's lying. He never conquered a country. He never took any war, and he never write anything. But yet he came to this world, present himself is the only way, the only true, and only life. And people follow him. Why? Because he's telling the truth. And I pray that tonight you'll find the truth, because Jesus Christ is the truth. And he will tell us where we're from. What's the meaning we live here? And he's going to tell us where we're going to go. Now, you're already here, so it is really doesn't matter whether you know where you're from. You're already here, so you can live your own life. But it's very important you need to know where you're going. Because this is coming, yet you are going to face the end of your life. Where are you going to go? A story talking about Einstein, Albert Einstein, one of the most wise person and the winner of Nobel Prize. And once that he took a train from Princeton to travel. So when the conductor came trying to punch the ticket and came to him, and he searched himself and cannot find tickets. So he looked into his bag, no ticket. Look in the seat, no ticket. Look everywhere, there's no ticket. And then the conductor said, well, Dr. Einstein, we know you, so we believe that you purchased a ticket, so you don't have to worry. Then just sit here and don't worry about the ticket. So he went, punched other passengers' ticket, but Einstein was so nervous and trying to find the tickets from everywhere, search all his bag, and she just cannot find the ticket. And finally, when the conductor is going to go to next session, he saw that Einstein is still searching, so he came back and says, oh, Dr. Einstein, don't worry, we know you, so you don't have to worry about the ticket. Then Einstein replied, son, I know myself also, but I don't know where I am going. The sad thing is that we think we know ourselves. But the sad thing is that a lot of people do not know where they're going. After this life, where are we going? Jesus Christ said that if we believe in Jesus Christ, then we're going to go to heaven and to be with him. He doesn't want anybody to perish. He wants everybody to get eternal life. So the Bible said, if you have Jesus, you have eternal life. This is the gift of God to everyone who desires to receive Jesus Christ. Now if you ask me to give you a water, so I give you a cup of water. And you say, no, I didn't want the cup, I just want the water. That's very difficult. If you accept the cup, then you'll be happy. You'll be able to have the water. Now the Bible is very clear. The Bible said that if you receive Jesus, then that's a gift of God. Then in Jesus, there's eternal life. So when you receive the cup, you have the water. When you receive Jesus Christ, you have eternal life. God wants everybody to have eternal life. The thing is, we need to receive Jesus in order to have this gift of God, eternal life. So I wish and pray that you will make a decision today to accept Jesus Christ, the gift of God, and to have eternal life. Let's pray. Father, we are so grateful for this evening that we can see the performance and we can also enjoy the content of this hymn and song and enjoy Jesus Christ. He is the answer of a human being because this is the truth. And so when we receive Jesus, we have this blessing of gift, eternal gift from the Lord to have eternal life. So we don't have to face the condemnation on death. So as we pray together, how many of you will decide to receive Jesus as the gift of the Lord? And if that's the case, would you raise your hands and say, Lord, help me. I want to have this gift of Jesus. I want to have eternal life. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you. Anymore. God bless you. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Anymore. Don't miss this time. Great. Father. Wonderful. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Father, we are grateful. Many hands raised to receive this eternal life through Jesus Christ. And I wish and pray for those who raise hand, and they will truly find him and come to the church to find out how to deeply know Jesus Christ. And all the other friends and visitors, I do also pray that they will remember only need to receive Jesus Christ, then we will have eternal life. Thank you for this time, bless each one of us, and use it mightily for thy glory. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Mr. Smith.
We'd like to conclude this evening by briefly welcoming and recognizing and thanking the musicians and performers this evening. I'll first mention the violinist. On violin, we had Faith Ellis Bautista, Christiane Way, Christiana Way, Krista Smith, and Nathan Smith. Let's thank them. On piano, accompanying many of our choir songs this evening was Krista Smith. Our wonderful voices this evening, we'd first like to recognize Mrs. Marshall and the kindergarten choir. And the lower elementary, upper elementary, junior high, high school, and university choirs. And finally, Dr. Yoshirato joining us from Guam. I'd also like to take this time to thank our generous sponsors who sponsor the university in their fundraising efforts. They're in the program. Those are the JET Holding Company, Shining Star Hotel, National Office Supply, and Hobbies Party Supply, Sports and Recreation. Please stand, and Dr. Way would like to dismiss us in a word of prayer. Please stand.
Let's pray together. Our Father, we are so grateful for this evening. We have a wonderful night. Thank you, Father, for the hard work of our teachers and the students. May the Lord bless them. And also thank you, Father, for our parents and our guests and visitors who come over. And we are so blessed with their attendance. And also we do thank you, Father, for those people who make the decision and to decide to trust the Lord. I do pray, Father, that will be with them. And bless all of the people and give us a wonderful evening to continue to be blessed by thee. Thank thee, Father, be with us as we dismissed. Please continue to care for us. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you so much. We'll see you next time.